From Television City in Hollywood, the Jack Benny program with his guest stars, Audrey Meadows and Dennis Day.
Thank you very, very much, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the program. You know, since you saw me last, I was in Chicago where I gave one of my violin concerts at the Chicago Civic Auditorium. And I want to tell you, of course I enjoy these concerts, but it was such a thrill, you know, working with this great Chicago Symphony Orchestra. And it was conducted by Mr. Walter Suskin, who is one of our greatest conductors. And he's very, very clever, too, you see, because during my violin solo, in order to get me to follow him and the orchestra during my number, he tied a dollar bill to the end of his baton. And this little device not only got me through my concert number, but I followed him all the way home to his hotel room. And this wasn't easy, considering that he took a cab and I ran. But you know, ladies and gentlemen, we have so much on this show that I don't want to take up a lot of time talking. So I would like to present to you immediately a fellow you always enjoy seeing, my singing star, Dennis Day.
Tonight, I would like to sing The Twelfth of Never. If you please, Mr. Merrick.
Wait a minute, Malin. Hold it. Dennis, what's the idea of rushing into your song? I want to talk to you first.
Well, I don't want to talk to you.
What?
You hired me to sing a song, and that's what I'm going to do. If you please, Mr. Merrick. Hmm?
What's bothering you?
Well, I'll tell you what's bothering me. The last time you used me was on the opening show of the season. That was 5 months ago, and you haven't used me since.
Well, Dennis, there's a reason for that. After all, you know how the way my shows are constructed. It's only a half hour, and I have to make everything tie in. Have you fit into the show?
Oh, sure. Excuses. I wouldn't mind if I hadn't been with you for so many years. If I haven't grown to admire you as a performer and developed such a deep sense of loyalty and devotion.
Well, really, I appreciate your loyalty, but... Well, now, take the last program that I did 2 weeks ago. How would you fit in there?
I don't know. I didn't see it.
Well, what about my program before that one?
I didn't see that one either.
All right, what about the program before that?
I didn't see it.
Dennis, you never watch any of my shows, and you call that loyalty?
Well, certainly. I don't want to sit there and watch an old man go downhill.
Downhill?
Sure, I prefer to remember you when you were in your heyday. We used to come out on the stage and sing, "And when my baby smiles at me." Oh, there's such a wonderful light. The shines in your eyes.
Wonderful.
And then you go into your short suit, you know. And then you grab hold of the bass. Then you switch to the slide trombone.
Dennis.
Then you sit down on the piano and you belt out
wait a minute,
four
wait a minute,
or five
Dennis,
tunes.
Dennis, hold.
Wait a minute.
I don't play a piano or a bass fiddle or a trombone. I can't sing and I can't dance.
Well, that's why I don't watch you. You're nothing.
Frank Park.
wealth of never, I'll still be loving you.
There's no denying that Dennis has a beautiful voice, and it gets better every day. And, of course, that's what aggravates me. You know, I just hate to stand here and watch a young man go uphill.
No, I told you it's no imposition for me to feed your cats while you visit your mother in Jersey. No, I've already bought the cat food. What? No, I can't keep the cats here in the house. You know how allergic Ralph is to cat food. Fur. Yeah, you know how he always sneezes every time I wear that mink stole he bought me. Yeah, well, don't you worry about it. I'll take care of it. Okay, bye-bye. Come on in, Ed.
Hey, Alex. Hey, Alice, are you psychic or something?
Well, what do you mean?
Well, when I knocked at the door, you said, come on in, Ed. How'd you know it was me?
When a man works in a sewer all day, he doesn't exactly need a calling card.
You're a cute kid, Alice. You're a cute kid. Hey, that's pretty fancy duds you got here, Alice.
Oh, yeah, but be careful, Ed, because they're not mine. I'm just doing alterations on them to make a little extra money.
Oh.
Hey, Ed, would you thread this needle for me, please?
Yeah, sure. Hey, Alice, how come you want to make this extra money?
Well, it's really a secret, Ed, but you know how crazy Ralph is about bowling. And he's just had his heart set on getting a new bowling ball.
Yeah, those cantaloupes he's been using sure been messing up the alleys.
Spending and saving for some time. He finally had $4.89 put away. So I took his money and added mine to it, and I bought him a new bowling ball. It'll be delivered this afternoon.
Hey, Alice.
Thank you, Ed.
Looks like I tried to knot Timmy's finger. Well, I guess I'll be going, Alice.
Oh, listen, Ed, will you watch out for Ralph? And if you see him coming, let me know.
Yeah, sure, okay.
All right. Hello? Oh, what's it now, Clara? Yeah, I told you got the cat food. Uh-huh. I think I got the kind you told me. Wait a minute. Kitty cat food number 3. It contains ground up fish heads, tripe, chopped chicken feet, phosphate, and cod liver oil. Uh-huh. Yeah, just getting ready to feed them now. Oh, you don't feed them till 7 o'clock. Oh, all right, I'll wait till then. Will you stop worrying? All right, bye-bye.
Hey, Alice, I just saw Ralph walking up the walk.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, Trixie, hoist the wing.
Supper.
Wait a minute. Don't you notice anything?
No. No, I don't, Ralph.
Look around.
What am I supposed to notice?
I'll tell you what you're supposed to notice. I'll tell you what you're supposed to notice. Stopped in a drugstore today, weighed myself, and I have lost a half a pound.
You expected me to notice that. The half a pound must have come out of your head.
You are a riot, Alice. You are a riot!
Well, will you calm down? I know you're always tired and irritable when you get home from work, but just calm down. I'll get my apron and I'll come back and fix you supper.
Yeah, dirty old. Now's my chance to deposit some money on my bowling ball account. Hey, the money is gone. The whole 48 not. Hey, Alice! So here's where my 489 went. An inside job. Alice! Alice, come out here!
What is it, Ralph?
Look at me.
Don't tell me you lost another half a pound.
Never mind that. I'm talking about these.
Oh, Ralph, it's not what you think.
It doesn't make any difference what I think. It'll hold good in any court in a minute.
But, Ralph...
Can't understand you, Alice. I can't understand you. I don't know what you want, Alice. I don't know what you want. Just tell me, Alice, what do you want?
A revolving room so you could stand still.
You're asking for it, Alice. You're asking for it. Now, those dresses go back in the morning or you'll be the best dressed woman on the moon. How is Joe?
Please don't send me away. I couldn't bear to leave all this luxury.
Don't see me, Alice. Don't see me. You're never satisfied with anything, are you?
Never satisfied with that. First thing I know you want some new drapes. Some new curtains. New curtains. The next thing you want is some wall-to-wall carpeting.
Oh, no, Ralph. No, I don't think I'll ever need that. With you around, we've got wall-to-wall fat.
Wall-to-wall fat. Hardy, har, 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 har.
Will hear you.
I want them to hear.
Now,
I want all of them.
Quiet.
All of them. Hardy,
Ralph Raymond, there is just no use in even trying to talk to you. Now sit down and I'll get you your dinner.
I'll get my own. I don't need you. Tuna salad.
That happened.
Why?
Hey, you rugby boy. How's my old bowling buddy?
So, Horton.
No money for two.
Join me.
Some coffee?
You know something, Ralphie? All of a sudden, I got a strange feeling that I want milk.
I never heard of that.
I have.
We don't need you.
Hello? Oh, yes, Clara. Oh, you don't have to go visit your mother in Jersey. You can feed the cats yourself. No, I won't be stuck with the cat food. Ralph and Norton are eating it now.
Didn't you hear what she said? That's cat food.
That beats anything that Trixie ever made.
Norton, you are an idiot. You are a mental.
Now get out of here. Might as well turn out. Turn on the light in the hall.
I won't have to. I got a feeling I could see in the dark.
This is all your fault, Alice. If it weren't for those threats.
Come in.
Package for Mrs. Ralph Ramsden?
Yes, thank you. I'll take it.
So another package, eh? Well, that goes back to the store. Back to the store. I can't do anything about the dresses.
But this hat goes back to the store.
To my loving husband, from Alice. For me?
That's right, Ralph. That's why those dresses were here. Just wanted to make some extra money to add to your money and buy you the bowling ball.
Baby, you're the greatest. Gentlemen, and I certainly want to thank Jackie Gleason for letting us do this. To the courtesy of Tootshore, by the way. And, Audrey,
yes,
I want to tell you, to me it was just wonderful. Here you play this in New York, and yet you come over here, and you spend all these days here in California, and yet you were able to stay in that same mood. I mean, how did you do that?
Well, Jack, that was easy after living in that hotel room you got me.
Well, you said you want to be centrally located.
Yes, but I want to be in Hollywood, not Glendale.
But the hotel is in Hollywood.
They moved it during the night to make room for a freeway.
They moved the hotel while you were in it?
That's right, Jack, and there's nothing sadder than looking out a window and watching an old hotel go downhill.
Well, you're... Audrey... It was just wonderful having you.
Thank you,
show.
Jack. I thought Dennis did a great job, too.
So did I. Hey, Dennis, come out here.
Yes. Oh, Jackie boy, we should do it.
Audrey thought you were wonderful, you know?
Oh, never mind the talk. Where's the check?
Boom! Get out!